We're so grateful and thankful that the Lord has once again allowed us to come to you by way of YouTube. It is my prayer that you had a gracious and a safe Thanksgiving, that you gave God, as we all did, I hope, all the glory and all the praise, and our families are safe. And those that was traveling made it back safely. And now we are into the great month of December. December is probably one of the most popular months of the year. And this is the month that we celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And if you were born in December, we want to take this time to wish all of those that was born in December a happy birthday. I wish I could sing, I would sing it to you, but just let me say to all of you that was born in December, happy birthday. We pray that birthdays are celebrated by way of giving God thanks and giving God glory and praise, because he didn't have to do it to allow us to live to see another year. So I think it's biblical to celebrate your birthday in the presence of the Lord, or with the Lord in mind. So as you come to your day this month in December, as we all do, each month when your birthday comes, you give the Lord thanks and praise. So let me just again say happy birthday to all of those that was born in December. We come to another period in our church where our hearts are a little saddened because another soldier has gone home. Sister Lois Ford, a longtime member of Greater Second, children was here. They was here when I came here in 79. She is the daughter of the late Mother Thelma Jones and the sister of Aberdeen Jones and Zenobia Joan Lovelace. And that service of Miss Ford will be here at the Greater Second Baptist Church on Monday at 10 o'clock a.m. And we just want that family to know that we love them. Our prayers are with you, and we'll be here with all of our support on Monday. Until we see you Monday, just know that earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal.
Welcome to Rise Up and Follow Jesus Christ with Pastor David Featherstone, the video ministry of Greater Second Baptist Church. Today, Pastor Featherstone wants you to know
the sheep responsibility to the shepherd is to respect and appreciate the shepherd, to esteem him very highly because of the work, and then to be submissive to leadership.
We want to welcome you to our fellowship of believers. Now, let's prepare our hearts and our minds in the worship of our Lord through the discovery of His Word.
This is another day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. I want you to know how grateful I am to yet be able to come to you with God's word. It's a joy. It's a task, but yet it's a joy to be able to proclaim the word of our Lord Jesus the Christ. We are thankful to this church, and we hope and pray that as we continue worshiping away from the building, that we are doing it in our homes, and we are being safe, but we are still worshiping the Lord. We're going through a series, as we shared with you the last time, a good series, I think, as Paul closes the book of 1 Thessalonians. He gives the closing part where he gives various exhortations. And I took part of those exhortations and converted it into what I know will be a four-part series. And last week and this week is kind of interchangeable. The title of the message, the series, is Growing a Healthy Flock. That's the series. The title of the series is Growing a Healthy Flock. And last week, we took that first message where if we're going to have a healthy flock, then it all is dependent upon relationships. I want to say that again because we got to understand that the church was never to exist without interaction with one another. We are a family. We are the body of Christ. And whenever there is a body, there got to be responsibilities for various parts. But all of the parts work together to make the body healthy. And so we come last week to bring you the message entitled The Relationship Between Shepherd and Sheep. And let's just call it shepherd to sheep. That's a relationship. Shepherd to sheep relationship. And that was verse 12 and 13. And we're going to use those same verses because of the title of today's message. Let me read it again, coming from the New King James Version, beginning at verse 12 of chapter 5. Paul says, and we urge you, brethren, to recognize those who labor among you and are over you in the Lord, and admonish you, and to esteem them very highly in love for their work's sake. Be at peace among yourselves. The title of today's message is The Relationship Between Sheep and Shepherd. Last week, it was shepherd to sheep. This week is sheep to shepherd. The relationship must be healthy between the shepherd and the sheep. The relationship got to be healthy between the sheep and the shepherd. We are the team when we look at the flock. We are the church. We're using the word flock. Isn't it amazing when we read the Bible how often we are characterized as sheep? Think about it now. If you have never Googled sheep, it may be a good exercise for us to go and Google the whole makeup of a sheep. Now, I'm not going to deal a whole lot with that, but I just want you to know that God calls us sheep. And one of the reasons that I think he referenced us as sheep is God used that title for his people to show the need for a shepherd. That title, sheep, does not grant us a high level of intelligence. I don't want to bust your bubble, but when God calls us sheep, he's not giving us a whole lot of intelligent credit, but rather just the opposite. When he gives us, now I'm serving as under shepherd, but I'm a sheep too. All of us are sheep in God's shepherding business. But there are some qualities of a sheep I just want to give you in my introduction. According to commentary, and as you Google it, you'll find that they probably say the same thing. A sheep does not have good eyesight. A sheep does not have good eyesight. A sheep will basically follow and run astray. A sheep, it don't see very well, so it can always be led off into danger. A sheep requires feeding. A sheep cannot feed himself. A sheep needs somebody to provide food in order that they might eat. And then a sheep need to be protected from wolves. Out in the prairie, out where the shepherd and the sheep is passing or crossing, moving from one place to another, there was always the wolves wanting to attack the sheep to acquire a good meal. Another thing about a sheep, and you ain't gonna like this one, a sheep is basically a dumb animal. A sheep is not very smart. A sheep got to be led. And so God gives us in the church under shepherd. He gives us somebody inside of the flock or inside of the congregation that he assigns to lead the sheep, to lead the flock, to feed the flock, to protect the flock, to provide guidance to the flock, and to keep the flock focusing on the great shepherd, the Lord Jesus Christ. And so that relationship between shepherd and sheep and shepherd got to be one where it is appreciated. It is a healthy relationship. That relationship cannot be at odds with one another. Let's go into today's message. We don't have to review last week. You can look at, I gave you the responsibilities basically last week of the shepherd. And Paul is talking to Christians. He's talking to the church at Thessalonica. And he says in verse 12, and we urge you, brethren, to recognize, that's our first word there, recognize those who labor among you. So Paul says to the church at Thessalonica, I want you to recognize those. Another word, I think the new American Standard, the New International Version, gives us a good word. Another word for recognize is respect. What Paul is saying to the church is there need to be a level of respect for those who labor among you. He said you ought to respect them, appreciate them for their work's sake or for their value. One of the things, and I'm not here today to try to get brownie points for the pastor. I'm here today to try to teach God's word where we all get a clear understanding of what Scripture says about this healthy relationship. Because the church will not be a growing, healthy church if we don't have these relationships intact with God's word. So he says that, brethren, I encourage you, I urge you that you ought to respect and appreciate those who labor among you. He said, now, the reason I need you to respect and appreciate them is because of their work. Their work is valuable. Their labor among you, they're working to exhaustion among you. And then I need you to appreciate them. I need you to respect them because they are over you in the Lord. They are the one that God has placed in charge of the flock. I said this last week, and let me just say it again for clarity, is we are called under shepherds. I know we shepherd the flock, but we are under the chief shepherd. We are under the great shepherd. We are those who work for the master. We are those who did not call ourselves, but he called us and placed us to be in charge of the flock. Let me read a verse I think that will help us. If you have never read this, you might want to read Acts chapter 20, verse 28. Paul is speaking in this, but also Luke is writing this, and he says in verse 28, therefore, so you got to go back and read what he says above there. Therefore, take heed to yourselves. Take heed to yourselves and to all the flock among which the Holy Spirit has made you overseer to shepherd the church of God, which he purchased with his own blood. Paul says that I need you to take responsibility. I need you to be aware that you need to realize that the Holy Spirit, this humbles every true pastor. This ain't nothing to for us to get the big head. This keeps us on our knees. He says, now I want you to understand that the Holy Spirit has made you overseer to shepherd the church of God. I want you to make sure you understand, I know the church voted. I know the church had a meeting. I know the church decided with popular vote who would be the pastor. But I want you to know that this whole idea of shepherd and overseeing was something of God's movement, and the Holy Spirit has placed in charge of the flock those whom God wanted to use. And if that don't humble us, I don't know what will. He says, now I need you to understand this, that you're to shepherd the church of God. You're to lead, you're to feed, you're to watch over the church of God. And this is the part that we don't want to miss, which he purchased with his own blood. Every time I read that, every time I think about that, I am humbled, because this is a God decision. This being able to shepherd the church of God is something that we are not to take lightly. And he says, Paul says in 1 Thessalonians, that the sheep, the first responsibility you got for the shepherd is to respect him or her or appreciate them because of the work and the responsibility God has placed on them to shepherd you, to lead you, to teach you, to help correct you. Because he said admonish you. Admonish has the idea of correcting. As the shepherd in the literal sheep business had a hook, and the hook was, one of the functions of the hook was to reach and get the sheep out of danger and pull them back in line. And that has the same view as the word admonish. Admonish, when it says admonish you, it is the idea that the shepherd is to help correct you when you are going in error. One of the worst things I think the church can do, and we'll get to some of this next week, week after next, when it's the third message, which is going to be sheep to sheep. But one of the worst things we can do as a church or any church is to have members that you see going wrong and you encourage them to keep going wrong. That's sinful. One of the things we've got to make sure that we understand is we all want to try to be better, do better, and the Bible will help us, but we cannot have sheep going against the Bible and then being encouraged to keep going that way by other sheep, but the shepherd sure enough cannot afford to have a sheep going in error and not try to correct. One of the jobs we have is to admonish you or to try to correct you in the Lord according to Scripture. So respect and appreciate. I know I'm going over that word a lot, but I've even heard said by some members, maybe not this church, but just members in particular, when there are problems in churches, I gave that pastor peace of my mind. Well, that's not a good saying to say about your pastor. That's not a good something to have written on your achievement list, that you gave the pastor a piece of your mind. Look, pray for your pastor. Encourage your pastor. Do all you can to help him. Don't be a burden to him, but make sure that you respect him. Pastor Wright Allen, y'all know I mention him a lot, but that relationship that Pastor Wright Allen and I had was one that even the city knew it was a good relationship. And one of the things that I made sure that I always done with Pastor Wright Allen was I respected him. I did not agree with him always, but I respected him. He always would get respect. Many times we would disagree, but we never disagreed publicly. I was always either in the car or at his house or at Denny's. And we would voice our disagreement. He'd voice what he didn't like, I'd voice what I didn't like. But it was always respectful. He was always my leader. He was always my pastor. And I always provided him with the best respect that I always did. I didn't, I very seldom called him Reverend Wright. I called him preacher. We had that relationship. He was always pastor. And so that's the relationship that I look back at and see. Before I became a pastor, I had to live as one of the sheep under the pastor. And it's hard to ever get promoted to leadership if you've never been a good follower. So I learned how to follow under the great leadership of Pastor Curtis Rideout. And so I want you to know that respect, I guess that's about the fifth or sixth time I've said that, isn't it? Respect. Make sure that you provide respect to your leader, because God says that's what part of your responsibility is. The second word that comes in mind, I'm going to read it again, verse 12. And we urge you, brethren, to recognize those who labor among you and are over you in the Lord, and admonish you. And here we go. And to esteem them very highly in love for their work's sake. So now we come to the word esteem very highly. Esteem them. Congregations are to think rightly and lovingly of the pastor or the under shepherd. You don't never want your mind and your attitude and your conversation to be one of unkind or down in the dump about your pastor. You're always talking about him. You don't have nothing good to say about him. You're always looking for the negative. That's word esteem means holding them up, lifting them up. Think rightly and lovingly of that pastor under shepherd. Here we go now. Not because of their charm or personality. And you know, you got some pastors that's very charming, got a very good personality, and we all ought to have a good personality. But that ain't the reason you ought to esteem them highly. Paul said here, but because of the fact that the work, because of the fact that they work for the chief shepherd. They are under the Lord. And the reason you ought to do that is because they are servants of God Almighty. They are servants of Jesus Christ. So you ought to esteem them highly because of their work's sake. You heard me read Acts about the Holy Spirit has made us overseers. But let me tell you what Peter said in 1 Peter chapter 5, verses 2 through 4. 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 2 through 4. He says, shepherd the flock of God, which is among you, serving as overseers, not by compulsion, but willingly, not for dishonest gain, but eagerly, not as being lord over those entrusted to you, but being examples to the flock. And when the chief shepherd appears, you will receive the crown of glory that does not fade away. Paul says that when you look at the work of the under shepherd, when you look at his calling, when you look at what God has placed for him to do, when you look at his being a servant of God, he's saying you want to esteem him. You want to think rightly. You want to think lovingly about him. You want to do everything you can in love, nothing in retaliation or hatred, because he works for the chief shepherd as his special servant. Let me close. And always try your best to be submissive. Be willing to submit to their leadership. And the reason you want to always have that submission spirit, in order that the church might have peace. He says, esteem them very highly in love. Do it in love now. Do it in love for their work's sake. Because of the work, you want to give them that highly esteem, very highly. Esteem them very highly. Think rightly of them. Think lovingly of them because of the work. And then he says, be at peace among yourselves. Submission is the key word. Being able to submit to leadership so that peace prevails in the church. The church is not supposed to be at odds among herself, among one another. I will never take my hand and beat my foot because they are the same body. I'm always, if there's an itch because of dry skin on my foot, I'm going to use my hand to scratch that itch, put lotion on that itch to try to help that itch feel better. But I'm never going to use one part of my body to hurt the other part of my body, because that'll have the body at odds. And in the church, many times, we're at odds. And to grow a healthy church is where the sheep got to submit to the leadership of the shepherd, because that's what's going to cause peace to prevail in the church. Peace, the absent of disruption, the absent of chaos, peace, calmness, regardless of what's going on. Now, you know, in the midst of this coronavirus, this pandemic we're in, my wife and I was talking, one of the things that God has given us is a spirit of peace. We're not worried. We're not at odds. We are at peace in ourselves, with God, and with one another. So let me close by saying the sheep responsibility to the shepherd is to respect and appreciate your shepherd, to esteem him very highly because of the work, and then to be submissive to leadership that peace may prevail in the church. If you and I will do that, I will provide the good relationship as shepherd to sheep, and you will come back and provide a good relationship between sheep and shepherd, then the growth of a healthy church will be on the move, because we got those two groups now working closely together. Let me say, if you've never accepted Jesus Christ, we want to offer him to you by faith. By faith that God sent Jesus, and Jesus came into the world to pay for our sins. He didn't come to do a lot of good things for us other than die for us. So he came to save us. And now that he died on the cross, buried him, and he rose the third day morning, he's saying to you and anybody else that's not saved, come. Come unto me, all you that labor and heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. Come, be born again. Accept the Lord Jesus Christ as your personal Savior, and then mature and allow him to become Lord of your life. And you do that by faith. He died, he buried him, and he rose the third day morning with all power in heaven and earth in his hand. Let me say to all of you God bless you this day and always is our prayer. Prepare your hearts for communion with me, please. Let's always remember that there are two ordinances that Christ gave to the church. One is baptism, and the other one we call the Lord's Supper or communion. And we come every first Sunday that we might commune together, because the word said, Jesus' own words to the disciples that night before the crucifixion, he tells them, I will not do this again with you until I do it anew in my Father's kingdom. But as often as you do it in remembrance of me, or you do it remembering me. Let us commune together, remembering our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Let's make sure that we continue to grow a healthy flock. That will be done by relationships. The first relationship is the relationship between shepherd and sheep. The next relationship is between sheep and shepherd. And then the next time we have together, we will talk about the relationship between sheep and sheep. Continue to love God. Continue to love one another. Continue to proclaim the good news. And continue, let's make disciples of Jesus Christ as we go. God bless you this day and always is my prayer.